Scleroderma is an autoimmune rheumatic connective tissue disease that literally means hardening of the skin. Sclero means hard and derma is skin. And it occurs when your body, instead of attacking only foreign invaders like viruses or bacteria or abnormal types of cells like cancers, starts to focus on your own body and cause damage. And when patients develop scleroderma, one of the things that happens is you can develop an increased production of normal collagen. Collagen is a structural protein that helps in repairing damaged tissue or forming scar in normal people. In scleroderma, the body has a hard time knowing when to stop laying down collagen. So large amounts of normal collagen are laid down, either in the skin or internal organs such as the lungs, and that can really negatively impact function, whether that's stiffening of the skin that can interfere with mobility, or stiffening of the lungs that can interfere with breathing. So there are two types of scleroderma. One is known as diffuse cutaneous scleroderma, and the other is limited cutaneous scleroderma, and they're essentially the two main categories of systemic sclerosis, meaning the type of scleroderma that can affect your internal organs. These two types of scleroderma are really distinguished by where your skin is thick. So if patients are considered limited scleroderma, they'll have skin thickening below the elbows, below the knees, and on the face. Whereas patients with diffuse scleroderma tend to have more proximal areas of skin thickening, including the chest, abdomen, upper arms, or thighs, which may occur in addition to the areas where limited patients are affected.